This is the second video in a series on home automation basics. I'll be covering everything from essentials like scenes and modes, automations, geofencing, voice assistants, and how to secure your smart home devices. In the last video, I walked through the different smart home platforms and technologies. If you haven't seen that one yet, I'll include a link in the description, or you can just back up one video in the home automation basics playlist. In this video, I'll be jumping into scenes. While I will be giving examples from different systems like SmartThings, Google, Amazon, Apple, and others, this is meant to be a platform agnostic view on home automation. These core concepts apply no matter what system you're using. If you're just getting started, then this is the series to watch. If you're already building out your smart home, this still may spark some ideas. But before we dive in, take a moment and hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on the full series of these videos. I'm Matt Ferrell. Welcome to Undecided. Since you're watching this video, I'm sure you already have a basic understanding of what a smart home is. You may have seen ads for Philips Hue light bulbs or received an Amazon Echo Dot or Google Home Mini as a gift over the holidays. There's no shortage of small gadgets and smart home devices getting pushed on the market, but it's often that first device that gets you wondering what else you can do. Smart homes are so much more than just being able to turn a light bulb on or off with your phone. At a surface level, it looks like these are just eye candy or a parlor trick and don't have much use. Or that there's no real meaning or purpose to the technology. So why even bother? The reality is that smart home technology adds more than just convenience to our lives. It can help energy conservation, home security, and even accessibility. Before you can unlock the real benefits of smart home technology, though, you have to be able to jump in, set it up, and start finding ways to apply the technology to your daily life. And that's where things fall a little short right now, and it's why I put these videos together. There's so much potential here, but smart homes are still a bit confusing to get up and running. One of the first things that you need to understand and master is scenes. It doesn't matter what system you're using, whether it's Philips Hue, Apple Home, SmartThings, Home Assistant, Lutron, you name it. One thing most of them have in common is scenes. So what are scenes? It's a memorized or pre-configured setting for specific smart home devices in a given location, like a room. Think about all of the lights that you turn on when you get home from work, or how you like to set your lights when you're eating dinner, or watching a movie in the living room. Most of us have more than one light you have to turn on, or window shades you like to close when you're settling in for the night. Well, you're basically just setting up lights, outlets, and devices turned on and to what level and saving that preset into your home automation app of choice. Then you can activate that scene at the press of a single button, talking to your voice assistant, or setting up routines to trigger that automatically, but more on that in a future video. In the Philips Hue app, all you have to do is tap on the New Scene button in the upper left-hand corner of the app. If you set up rooms, you tell the app which room this scene should be assigned to, name the scene, and select the lights you should turn on and to what levels. Do you like it dim? Then something like 30%. As an example, I'm going to set up a scene for helping to wake up. I'm going to select all of the lights in my bedroom. In the Hue app, I have a bunch of bulbs grouped to match color. If I wanted, I could drag any one of these out of that grouping and give that a unique color. Tap on each light and I can set the brightness level for that specific light. Tap on the group and I can change the brightness for all of the lights in that group. I'm going to do each light individually so I can set the headboard backlight a little brighter than the rest. Save it and I'm done. Now if I tap that scene, it will turn on every light to exactly how I configured it. In SmartThings, it's very similar. On the My Home screen, you tap on the Scenes tab, and then tap on Add a Scene. Select your devices that you want to control and what settings they should use. In Apple's Home, you tap on the plus sign in the upper right-hand corner and Add Scene. You can select from a suggested option or tap Custom to select specific devices and settings you'd like to use. It's again, very similar. Google Home is the odd service in this grouping here. While it supports scenes that you've created in other apps, like the Philips Hue app, you can't create scenes directly in Google Home. It's odd, and I'm hoping it's something that they add down the road, but for now, you have to rely on your smart home gadget maker's app to create those scenes for those devices, or to rely on Google's routines in the Home app. Routines in Google Home get you most of the way there, but there are some differences, and I'll get into that into a later video. For other devices, like the Ecobee thermostat, there aren't scenes, but there are something called comfort settings, which for all intents and purposes act a lot like scenes. You create a comfort setting for home, away, night, or anything else you want, which is where you assign temperatures, fan settings, and sensors to use. But in and of themselves, those comfort settings don't do anything. Use the schedule to activate those comfort settings at certain times, so in the case of an Ecobee, comfort settings are essentially scenes. Even if your device doesn't have explicit scenes by name, there may be similar functionality under another name. Keep an eye out for that. So why are scenes the first thing I recommend wrapping your head around and getting set up? First, it's for convenience. You'll be able to tap on a single button within an app and get the grouping of lights or devices to turn on to that specific brightness, color, temperature, or whatever the feature is. Second is for laying the groundwork for more robust automations with routines. You'll be able to set up a number of triggers that can automatically activate for a specific scene. For instance, if you want all of your living room lights to come on at 50% brightness when you get home, and you also want those same lights to be at 50% brightness when you're watching TV, then you can have an I'm home and watch TV routine that both activate the same 50% brightness scene. Change that one scene and both routines will get the updated settings. It makes it much easier to manage your smart home setup as it grows. And for the object-oriented programmers out there, this should feel right at home. In the next video, we'll be diving into routines and modes, so you definitely don't want to miss that one. We'll start building out triggers, tapping into those scenes from this video, and pushing things to the next level. Drop any questions you have in the comments, and let me know what systems you have in your house so far. And if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends because it really does help the channel. And if you'd like to support the channel, there's some more ways that you can do so. Check out my SFSF shop for some cool Tesla, SpaceX, Science, and Undecided t-shirts. There are other links in the description for some great Tesla accessories and discounts. And as always, an extra big thank you to all my Patreon supporters for making these videos possible. If you're interested in early access to videos, behind the scenes posts, check out my Patreon page for additional details. If you haven't already, consider subscribing and hitting that notification bell to get alerts when I post new videos. As always, thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.